pessoal, tudo bem com vocês? Hi everyone, how are you doing? A nossa aula de hoje será sobre algumas expressões como uma única palavra, a palavra pau, que os brasileiros falam muito. Today's class is about various expressions that Brazilian people use with the word pau, stick. So there are different ways to say different sentences with the word pau, stick. So let's see the first one. O estudante levou pau na prova. It means the student flunked the exam. The student flunked the exam. O estudante levou pau na prova. Então, o estudante não teve sucesso na prova. The student didn't succeed in the test, in the exam. So he flunked. Levou pau. O estudante, vocês podem repetir depois de mim. So you repeat after me. O estudante levou pau na prova. Ok? Repeat. Yes, good. Another one. Eles competiram pau a pau. They are neck and neck. Ok? They compete at the same level. The students, they compete at the same level. Eles competiram pau a pau. Neck and neck. Eles competiram, the verb to compete, eles competiram pau a pau. They are neck and neck. Neck and neck is a slang in English, né? É uma gíria, slang, gíria. Pau a pau, ok? É também uma gíria. É bem informal no português brasileiro. It's very informal way to say in Brazilian Portuguese. X meteu o pau no vizinho. X badmouthed his neighbor. Meter o pau no vizinho, ok? To badmouthed here means to say something bad about someone or about something. Ele, alguém, someone, meteu o pau no vizinho. Ok? So he said bad things about his neighbor. He badmouthed his neighbor. Repitam depois de mim. X meteu o pau no vizinho. Ok? Another one. X mostrou a Y com quantos paus se faz uma canoa. X touch Y a lesson. Literally, ao pé da letra, to the letter, we would say X showed. With how showed someone with how many sticks you can make a canoe. Ao pé da letra, literally, to the letter. X touch Y a lesson. Okay? Let's repeat. She's, someone, alguém, mostrou, o verbo mostrar está no passado, it's in the past participle, it's in the past, mostrou a Y com quantos paus se faz uma canoa? O plural de pau é paus. The plural of pau is paus. Canoa, canoe, literally. So, someone taught someone a lesson. Ele é pau para toda obra. He is an odd job man. Someone who does everything in the house, in the garden, a very helpful person. So, ele é pau para toda obra. He is an odd job man. Okay? A man who is a man who does many things, especially in a house, in the garden, etc. Ele, let's repeat, ele é pau para toda obra. Ele é um perna de pau. He is a cart horse. Significa que ele não joga bem. He plays very badly. Literally would be he has a leg of stick, or he has a stick leg. Mas não é assim que a gente fala, não é assim que a gente traduz. We don't translate this way. We translate this way. He is a cart horse. Ele é um perna de pau. When we say this to a person, to a man, to a girl, it's because he doesn't play a sport very well. Okay? So, ele ou ela é um perna de pau. Meu computador deu pau. My computer crashed. Meu computador deu pau. Okay, it broke. It's not running. It's not working. It's not functioning. So, my computer crashed. Meu computador deu pau, quebrou. Meu computador deu pau, it crashed. Ele é um santo do pau oco. He is fake. Someone who acts like a friend, but it's a false friend. It's not a friend. It's not a true friend. It's a false friend. Ele é um santo do pau oco. It's like a saint with a stick without a nucleus, okay? Oco, without nucleus. Ele é um santo do pau oco. He is fake. Repeat. Ele é um santo do pau oco. Ele é cara de pau. He is a cocksure. Ele é cara de pau. Ok? He is a shameless person. Ok? Audacious. He's an audacious person. Shameless person. So, he is a cocksure. Ele, repeat. Ele é cara de pau. Literally, cara, face, de pau, stick, like stick face. We don't say this. We say cara de pau. Cocksure. This is a big sentence. Ele chutará in the future. Chutará o pau da barraca quando vir o que aconteceu com o carro. He will blow his top when he sees what happened to the car. Ele chutará. Chutar, o verbo chutar, to kick, ok? To kick the whole thing down, to kick. O pau da barraca, the stick of the tent, ok? Literally, barraca, tent. When he sees o que aconteceu, what happened to the car. Então, let's repeat. Ele chutará o pau da barraca quando vir o que aconteceu com o carro. Another way to say this is he lost his temper. He lost his temper, ok? Ele perdeu a paciência. He lost his temper. Ele perdeu a paciência e chutou o pau da barraca. He lost his temper and kicked the whole thing down. Outra expressão muito falada. Another expression very said. Pau é pau e pedra é pedra. Like stick is stick and stone is stone. It is what it is. Okay? So, it's used to... it is what it is. So, it's used when we cannot answer a question adequately. Okay? So, when you don't have an answer to the question, you say, it is what it is. Pau é pau e pedra é pedra. It is what it is. Okay? Pau que nasce torto nunca se endireita. Once a villain, always a villain. Literally, to the letter, we would say, someone who is born bent, okay, will never straighten up. To the letter, okay? It is literally, but we don't say this. Once a villain, always a villain. In the place of a villain, you can say whatever you want. Pau, repeat after me. Pau que nasce torto nunca se endireita. Matar a cobra e mostrar o pau. I'll show you how it is done. Matar a cobra is like literally kill the snake and show the stick. But we don't say this. We say matar a cobra e mostrar o pau. Okay, I'll show you how it is done. So repeat. Matar a cobra e mostrar o pau. Nós temos dois verbos. We have two verbs. Matar, to kill, and mostrar, to show. Okay? Matar a cobra e mostrar o pau. Eles quebraram o pau. They had a huge bust up. They had a huge bust up. Eles quebraram o pau. Okay? They had a very bad argument. Quebrar, to break. Eles quebraram o pau. They broke the stick. But we don't say like this. We say eles quebraram o pau. They fought a lot. Okay? They had a bad argument. So, repeat after me. Eles quebraram o pau. Quebraram, do verbo quebrar. Ele ficou pau da vida. He got mad at someone, to get mad, or to become angry towards someone or something. Ele ficou pau da vida. Do verbo ficar. Ele ficou pau da vida. Vida, life. Ele ficou pau da vida. Let's repeat. Ele ficou pau da vida. He got mad. He got angry. So, if you find this video helpful, please give a like and a share. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel. And keep practicing your Brazilian Portuguese, okay? Bye-bye. See you.